You know, all this talk about we will escape all this persecution, it's just rubbish. I used to think like that. You know, every sincere Pentecostal believer or preacher knows by heart, without looking at the Bible, that the rapture will take place before anything else. Right? I'm sure you have held those old age thinking. I thought like that because I belong to the old school Pentecostal school, you know. We've been taught like that until the year 2006. In 2006, I was preaching at a convention in South India, and I was praying that morning, asking the Lord what I should share that evening. And the Lord Jesus came to me and He said, open your Bible and look at Matthew 24 verse 8. So I looked at the scripture. It says, all these are but the beginnings of sorrows. So I said, Lord, what is this? This is a good news convention. We are supposed to preach good news. Right? You don't say, these are the beginnings of sorrows. That's not good news. That's bad news. And the Lord went through the chapter 24 of every event that is going to take place in the last days. And then He went through with me Matthew chapter 24 and the books of Revelation. And that's when He said the church will go through the fire. I said, Lord, this is contrary. What you are telling me now is contrary to whatever we have known. And He said, all you guys are wrong. All you guys are wrong. He said, I never said in my word the rapture will be before the tribulation. Did He? No. This is how we interpreted it. Right? Because we like to escape all this thing. He said, you are wrong. It will go through. It will go through the fire. That will be the last final test of our allegiance. Amen. You know, you all are very smart people, aren't you? No? Yes. Why do you give me a stare then? Are you smart people? Yes. Okay. I'll give you a simple math, okay? It's a simple math. Not very difficult, rocket science. Now you just listen to me very carefully and use your logical reasoning now. If all the good people, good Christians, those who are walking with the Lord, they all are raptured, all gone. And only the nominal Christians and all the evil ones are left behind. Okay? Why force them to take the mark of the beast? Why force them? Because they all are prepared to take the mark of the beast. Why force them? Because they'll all be psycho-conditioned. They'll all be taught to receive and to know that the mark of the beast is okay. You know, I was just told by a minister of God in Singapore about a church elder of one of the largest church in Singapore. And the elder spoke with this minister of God that I know, a friend of mine, said, it is nothing wrong to take the mark of the beast. He is an elder in the largest church in Singapore. For the elder to speak like that, what must the church be teaching? Right? This minister friend of mine was shocked to hear this. He said, what do you mean it's okay? Yeah, he said, of course it's okay. Because God knows our hearts. Wrong. You see, this is the ploy of the devil. This is the subtle trickery of the devil. To deceive you into thinking, oh, the flesh is weak. God knows your heart. Just take the mark. It's after all in your hand, not in your heart. You see? But what goes in your hand is what goes into your heart. So if all the good people are gone, why need the false prophet and the antichrist force the people to take the mark of the beast? No need to, right? No need to. But for him to force the people, the remnant must be here, right? The remnant must be here. And then remnant will refuse to take the mark of the beast. And many of the remnant, according to Revelation chapter 20, will be beheaded. They die as martyrs because they refuse to take the mark of the beast. Then there will be another remnant who will be given great wings like an eagle to fly into the wilderness to a place that has been prepared for her, protected. Now that knocks out all this pre-tribulation rapture teaching. Right, everybody? Yes. It knocks it out. Clean and out. Knock out in the first round. Don't have to go through all the rounds till the last result. Don't have to. First round out. You know, that was how the Lord corrected me that day in the year 2006.